Hey everyone, hope you got your Springified Learning Path templates. They're so cute. And I've had a bunch of questions already about the digital stickers. And the first question was, how did I make them to have transparent backgrounds and words? And the second question was, how can I use these in my students to give them grades or feedback without having to go into the template to copy it and then go back into the student's work to paste it? So I'm going to show you both of those things really quickly, and then you're going to go try them on your own. So I create all my stuff inside of PowerPoint. So here you can see where I created all the learning paths. And actually, here is the slide where I was creating everything. So there's a bunch of extra stuff everywhere that doesn't make it to the final cut. But I can use this to show you how I made the digital stickers. The first thing that I did was purchase the unbelievably cute clip art from TPT. And I just searched cute clip art with bugs. And I found this amazing stuff from Jessie from Pignit. She is a super talented artist. So if you want, you can go check her out and get these for yourself so you can make some additional ones that match. So all I did was download her clip art, and then I inserted it here, and I just put the picture on top of a circle and on top of a word. That's all I did. So that was it. And then to get it into a sticker, all you have to do is put a box around it, and then I pressed Control C to copy it. And if you right click, you have a paste option that says paste as a picture. And I'm just going to click that, and it pasted it as a picture with a transparent background. Also on my circle, I added a shadow just to make it look a little bit more 3D. And so to do that, all you have to do is under shape effects, there's a shadow, and I clicked this middle one. So that is all you literally have to do to create stickers. You can right click on it and click Save as Picture, and then you can just save it into a file so that you have all of your digital stickers made. So now I'm going to show you how you can use the digital stickers really fast. This is a really cool tool. So I'm back in the Learning Path template, and I see all my new digital stickers. So all you have to do is right click on one of them, and at the very bottom of the menu it says Save to Keep. And so over here, this keep notes will pop up and you'll see it there. So I'm going to do that for a couple of them. Just right click, save to keep, save to keep. And so now I can close this keep box. And now any file that I go to, so let's say this is a copy that students are using. They're doing something here and I want to tell them that they did a great job. All you have to do is click the button right here, the keep icon, and it opens up all of the things that you've been saving to keep. And then the three little dots has the menu. You can delete it if you don't want it anymore, or you can click add to slide. And then it just puts it right there on the slide for you. And you can access all of these ones that you saved no matter which Google Slides file you go into. And you can add things to it from any slide. So maybe you want to add some of these stickers, just right click and click save to keep, and there it is. And now you can go back and try it again. So my challenge for you is to make some personalized stickers. Maybe yours can say, Miss Nowak misses you, or something like that, that the kids would love. And then use keep in order to make it easier to share those stickers. All right, bye.